Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel, and today I'm super excited because we're taking a look at one of my favorite ships in the game, and probably the best cruiser to learn how to play cruisers because it is an incredibly safe and easy ship to play, and that is the Belfast, an excellent ship that you can actually visit in London, which I did a couple of years ago, and I highly recommend you do so should you ever come to London, but you probably know that already. So what makes it such a great ship to play? Well, let's take a look at the stats. And if you're not interested in that and you want to continue with the gameplay, you can fast forward to 2 minutes and 30 seconds and you can take a look at the timestamps in the video description. So what makes it so great? Well, it's very easy to see. It's the 3 smoke 2 charges. These are absolutely amazing. With the proper captain, David Beatty, and the right captain skills, you will be able to hide in smoke for 40 seconds. That is absolutely incredibly safe. You can spend half the game hiding in smoke, shooting at enemy battleships or other cruisers. That's very, very good. And when you come up against destroyers, you do have sonar and radar, and that is very, very good at tier 7. So that ship is actually very good at dealing against every single target you throw at him. And it's also very survivable. You see 28,000 hit points for a light cruiser at tier 7. That is very, very good. The rest of the survivability stats are not bad either. The maneuverability is average, we're going to improve it with our equipment setup, but the main show for the Belfast are the 12-152mm guns with a very decent range of 11 kilometers and, surprise surprise, HE damage for a British cruiser. That is certainly a welcome addition. That will give you the flexibility to engage battleships, and you do have a decent chance of setting them on fire as well. That's certainly very good. The AP DPM is also not bad. You will see that the guns are actually quite accurate and reliably able to hit the weak spots of heavily armored battleships, and the nice turret traverse around 10 degrees is certainly very good. We'll still be improving that with our elite bonus. So unfortunately you do not get any secondaries or torpedoes, but don't worry, we are not going to be at a disadvantage when dealing with battleships at short range because of our smoke. And finally, the very decent DPM, and unfortunately not a lot of AA, this ship is not a support cruiser. We are back to the gameplay. We are immediately going to be aggressive and head towards the cap. You can take a lot of risk with that ship simply because you get 3 get out of jail for free cards with your smoke charges. And keep in mind that adding David Beatty to that ship will not only give you 6 sense, that will allow you to see how many ships are actually targeting you. That's a very, very nice skill to have when you are learning to play cruisers, because that's the kind of information that you desperately need. But you will also get an improved mist weaver. I'm going to show it now on the screen. So not only will it increase the duration and the size of your smoke screen, it will also reduce the cooldown, and by quite a lot. That practically means is you can remain hidden in smoke for 40 seconds with each charge, and you will only have to wait 20 seconds for your smoke screen to be available again. And that will make it incredibly safe for you to be engaging any target, because you will simply not be exposed. It's a very, very nice ship for that. That's why I'm saying it's very, very safe. Not only is it very survivable, it can engage every single target, from battleships to destroyers to cruisers. It's very good at dealing with destroyers, but it's not hopeless against battleships, even the tier 8 ones. And once you've gotten yourself out of trouble, you've been a little bit too aggressive, then that's okay. You can simply press smoke, pop smoke, and you disappear for 40 seconds, and you can actually take some time to think about your next move. So really, if there is one ship I have to recommend for people who are willing to invest some time in learning about cruisers, that is the Belfast. It is your safest option, and as you can see, it's quite powerful at dealing with other cruisers as well. If you watch the beginning of the engagement with that Pensacola, I was simply staying out of range. He did not have the range to hit back at the beginning of the engagement. Now that it's safe because I'm surrounded by my team, I can pursue him and I can actually hit him quite hard. So yeah, it's very, very good at dealing with other cruisers. Let's see how it performs against battleships, because I think that there is one that's coming to us. Yeah, there's a Colorado right in front. That's not going to take long before it actually starts engaging us. But let's finish that Pensacola first. Let's see if we can put a couple of shells into him. And hopefully this time it will be enough. The whole enemy team is there. I'm not going to go to the left because I'm not going to push my luck. But instead I'm going to do something that you should think twice about doing with any other cruiser, and that is engaging a Colorado in a 1v1. So this one, it's absolutely safe, that's alright. But this one, yeah, that's a little bit too close, and that's what I said. Usually what you would do here is you would actually start thinking about using torpedoes, but in a Belfast it's very, very safe. We'll be focusing on the weaker part of the armor of that Colorado. They're really going to take a couple of hits. Certainly we're going to use quite a lot of health because we are still a cruiser, but we are going to disappear immediately. And sure enough, we hide into smoke and we keep pumping AP shells into the weaker parts of the armor of that Colorado. And look how quickly it goes down. Look at that salvo. Excellent, that ship is absolutely excellent. So yeah, it's very safe. There you go, we just dealt with the Colorado. Okay, I had the support of another battleship, but that's alright. That's something that you can only dream about doing in other cruisers. And now it's time to be aggressive again and to turn back towards the caps, because we are certainly not winning this game. And let's see what we can do. So I'm not afraid of going a little bit more aggressive and a little bit more solo with that ship, simply because I do have that huge survivability, and when I look at the amount of smoke charges I have and the time left in the game, I will basically be able to remain in smoke for the rest of the game, so that's perfectly fine. So you do have a nice toolkit for dealing with destroyers as well, but if you cannot hit anything with your aiming, then yeah, the Belfast is not going to help you, unfortunately. And it's not helping me either. There you go, another destroyer as well. Oh, destroyers galore in that game. This time is our aiming a little better, let's see. Aye, not really. Okay, that's the main action for us. And now we are in a scenario where we are dealing with a battleship at range, and unfortunately, although we do have quite accurate, I will have to switch to HE, because I'm not going to be able to hit the weaker parts of the armor very reliably. And so after this salvo, I'm going probably to switch to HE, sure enough, and I'm going to hide in smoke, and I'm going to be putting hits and hits and hits into that Colorado until I set him on fire. Just to be very clear, the Belfast is not an HE spammer. You should think twice about the kind of ammo that you are using, at which range and against which target. Again, it's very excellent for learning how to switch between different ammo types on cruiser. You will learn that with that ship as well. And sure enough, we managed to set that Colorado on fire, and we will keep pumping damage safely from our smoke screen. Notice, by the way, that the ship is quite accurate. We are putting almost all of our shells into that target, so that's certainly very good. And although we are not dealing a lot of damage, we are certainly dealing a lot more than if we were trying to hit the weaker parts of its armor with AP, because at that range, and since it's relatively well hidden, that would be quite a challenge. Sure enough, are we going to set him on fire again? Because it's time to get some fire damage now. And sure enough, we're going to do it with that salvo. There you go, started moving again, so he missed, and I'm going to move back and forth. Our acceleration is certainly very good, and we've improved it, and there you go, second fire, and maybe a third one to finish him. And you see that we were only in the open for 20 seconds between our two smoke charges, so the ship is absolutely excellent, and yes, the Colorado is going down. But unfortunately, so is my team. We've only got 25 seconds left, and we're still quite far behind, so the DD gets taken down, that's very good. And we have another one right in front of us, 15 seconds left. Are we going to be able to finish this one? Certainly aiming for it, trying to avoid the torpedoes, and are we going to be able to do it's going to be close, and fuck. At the last second. Well done, Lebrecht Maas. So yep, one of those frustrating gameplays, but eventually a really, really nice one at showing you what the ship does well and does not do very well. There's not a lot that it cannot do very well. And yes, 1 second. Yes, that's life. Those things happen. What a fantastic machine. If you need to buy one cruiser this year and you want to get into cruisers, take this one and take Beatty as well. I can assure you, you will not regret it. It will serve you very, very well. And you will also be able to visit it in London. That's a picture I took, and look at that wonderful summer weather, British summer weather. Absolutely awful. So here we are. I hope you've enjoyed the guide. The second part will be a little bit more tactical. It will talk about how to best use your smokes, and I will publish it a couple of days later. So in the meantime, stay safe, take care. That was Death from Above, signing out. Bye bye.